Hey folks, Captain Kilt-Man here. Captain Kilt-Man at your Shoktober service. How are you? Hope you're all doing exceptionally well. I'm not going to leave it behind this time. Right, so, folks, a little quick video before I jet off on my jet skis to work. Bouncing across the River Mersey in a tempest at the moment. Yes, Japan's going to get Typhoon Haribo or Haggis, and it's going to lay waste to the fucking Rugby World Cup, and Scotland might not get their game, which they desperately have to win on Sunday against host nation Japan. What's going on? What's going on? Just delay the game. Postpone it. If the storm's going to hit, postpone the game. If they don't play and win, because they've declared it a draw between the two, well, Scotland have to win by a good, comfortable margin. Anyway, it's not why we're here. We're here because I thought it's absolutely persisting down. Oh, aye, but it's good Scottish rain. The rain is coming straight down and only slightly from the side. It's wet as hell out there. It's a water world. So, I thought, the remnants of a fish supper I had last night. I thought, yeah, let's do some more Jaws. Jaws, one of the biggest monsters, the biggest monster phenomenon, one of the greatest movies of all time. And then it got a sequel, Jaws 2. Which is actually really good. I do love the film Jaws 2. I think it's brilliant. And it's a great double bill. You've got Brody again, haven't you? You've got the same place, it's Amity. You've got the whole thing. It fits hand in mouth. And as it happens, there is a hand in that mouth. Look. That's Quint's hand. Quint, yes. Old barnacled Quint. But yeah, Spielberg did not return for Jaws 2. But John Williams, who created the dun, 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 and this theme, the Orcas theme, he returned to Jaws 2, directed by Jeannot Swark, or Jeannot Swark. And, but I'm not going to discuss the movie. No, we're going to play some music. You already heard the main theme creeping in there. And in this delicious continuation of his Jaws themes, he brings the harp in really, really well and creates, he almost enhances the undersea beauty and the enormity of the undersea kingdom and how we don't really belong down there at all. But he creates the majesty, the myth and the menace of the deep sea, you know, tracts and the things that lurk beneath those waves. Don't get any ideas. But yeah, so, out of Jaws 2, there's some great sequences, some great set pieces. My favourite, or one of my favourites, is the undersea ballet, the ballet for divers it's called, where a dive class, they get them all suited up, whoop, they go backwards over the boat, and they start, stay together guys, stay together. Of course one guy, swims off on his own. And it's not exactly crystal clear water, it's kind of really murky as hell. And John Williams paints this wonderful, majestic, sort of spellbinding undersea odyssey music. And it's just breathtaking, it's beautiful. It's soothing, but it's laced with deep, deep menace as well. And this guy, this dickhead, will see a spider crab going over some rocks, and he'll go for it. And it scampers over the top, and of course he goes over, and he goes into this other area. Ah, it's just so, so good. You would not venture into it. It looks like fucking something out of Sleepy Hollow, but underwater. There's like a forest of undersea vines, and it looks like a really thick forest, and it's murky, and you're like, don't go in there. Don't do it, man. Don't do it. And he begins to sort of prowl past this sort of undersea forest, just as he goes right past, and all of a sudden, this comes out and fucking just misses him. And in his panic, he bites through his snorkel, you know, his whatever you call it, his respirator. And it swims to the top, but he gets the bends because he's gone up too quickly. He hasn't depressurized. So, you know, Something down there must have scared him. You know, yeah, yeah, we fucking know. And of course, this shark that's already been burned, half its face is burned because of the attack on the water skier. And it kills the water skier, famous scene. And then it attacks the woman who's been driving the speedboat. And in a panic, she lifts up a can of kerosene and manages to pour it all over herself. The shark's fucking rocking the boat, literally. And she gets a flare pistol out, bang! Blows the fucking boat up, kills herself obviously, but burns the shark. So this shark has a hideous, scarred visage, which goes in tow with the fact that Jaws 2 is basically a teens in peril stalk and slash movie, where the teens are the usual teens who are isolated and cut off and getting picked off one by one by a scarred, hideous monster. In this case, it's a shark, but it's got that burnt Kruger face. Anyway, let's get on to this Ballet for Divers. Now listen up for the beautiful cello, but listen how John Williams brings in that core of menace, even when things are really beautiful and soothing and lilting, and you know, you still know something down here. Clever the way he does it. Hear the rain, can't you? Adds to the ambience. If you can hear that, it's very quiet. You know, it's unnerving, and yet it's captivating all at the same time. It'll begin to put a deeper chord of menace in earnest as he's drawn inevitably away from the pack into danger zone. Bubbles coming out, blood bubbles as well. His blood vessels are bursting. Doesn't kill him. But now, in a brilliant, brilliant sequence, following directly on from this, as they're getting back on the boat, you see the fin going past the dive boat. But in the distance are all the catamarans that these teens are on. Having a, you know, they want to go out day sailing, but they're going to go too far out. And the shark's going to head for them. So in this, what you're going to hear now, boat's in danger. The shark's fin goes past the other boat. You see them in the distance, he's heading for them. John Williams has this little dynamic action piece. Because they're all like that. You know, in the waves, in the wind, having a whale of a time. The piccolos and the shrieking strings. Horn. Jaws theme. There you go, folks. I'm going to leave it at that because I've got to go to work. Know what I do for a living? Sharking. I got the hands of a fisherman. Right, which means they stink of fish all the time. Don't make up any jokes about that. Right, folks, I'm going to leave it there because, real life doth beckon. And I'm sorry, the raging bloody tempest has kind of maybe lessened the sound quality of that, but you get the drift. Anyway, folks, take it easy. Stay out of the water, you know, and, watch out for things with big mouths. Like guys in kilts that like to have YouTube channels and don't know when to shut up. Take it easy. Be happy. Be safe. Be Kiltic. No, be Celtic. Be Kiltic. Yeah, I'll do. Drink whiskey. Be happy. And I'm going to see you all later. Shark! Shark!